It was a graveyard smash.
Hello, my lovelies. Welcome to my channel. Here we are doing all the monthly reading for each and every single one of the zodiac signs. I do want to let you guys know, for those of you guys that are trying to get private consultations, now is the time to reach out, as we are opening calendar and we're quickly booking, not just for this month, but for the remaining of the year. As you guys know, we're getting to the busiest season of the year for us. And we are, like I said, very quickly booking. So if you guys are trying to definitely keep your slot or get a slot for the private consultations, now is the time to do so. So let's get right into your reading. This is going to be for Leo, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. Let's see what Spirit has for you guys for the month of October 2019. Now, your first card here, Leo, is the Queen of Swords, okay? You have the Lover's card, the Moon card, the Eight of Pentacles, the King of Pentacles, the Six of Swords, oh, wow, the Wheel of Fortune, the Two of Swords, the Nine of Wands, and the Devil card. Okay, so you do have a lot of similar cards. Yeah, I see a few similar cards to the ones that Cancer got. So if there's any type of connection with the Cancer, I definitely encourage you guys to watch that video as well. Or if you are... if you're being what is it called? If you are being a, what is it called? A floater, or you're looking at someone's Leo sign and you yourself may be a Cancer, then there you go. That's the connection. But I definitely do see a lot of cards here that came out in the Cancer reading. All right. So for the month of October, what we see here is there's going to be tons of situations and experiences. That's if you're not already experiencing this, Leo. People coming back into your life, people from the past. This could be friends. This could be romantic lovers. This could be people that just had bad timing around the time that you guys met. Not necessarily just love. It could be like business and finances as well. A lot of people resurfacing. And what they're saying is that the reason for this is because you guys are currently experiencing almost like a burst of cleansing or purging. So anything that was left unsaid or left undone, those situations are going to come back around, or those people in particular are going to be coming back around, trying to reach out to you, trying to mend the fences, etc. So I definitely do see almost like almost feeling like a bit overwhelmed, depending on the people that are reaching out to you. So you do have here the Queen of Swords, and the Queen of Swords is, I feel like this is the energy that you're taking on for this month of October. And what they're telling you is, Leo, if you guys are currently single, now is the time to put yourself out there and to mingle. Stop being so very methodical, or stop being so much in your head, almost like feeling very self-conscious about yourself. Or it could be that you're very judgy to other people or the people that are around you that may be interested in you. What they're telling you is that there's going to be some type of development in regards to a relationship, perhaps with a person. It could be a person that you work with. It could be a person that you're not even aware that they're interested in you. And there is a circumstance, almost like you guys have a conversation and you find out that you guys have excuse me, a lot of things in common, or that they have something in common with you, Leo. And again, I feel that there's going to be almost a feeling like, oh, okay, I didn't know that you were into, you know, you were into this, or I had no idea that you like to go out and have fun. For some of you guys, this could be an earth sign. It could be a Capricorn, Taurus, Virgo. It could be a Capricorn, as we do have the Devil card here. For others of you, it could be a Pisces or a Cancer. Again, I'm hearing Cancer. So if you are currently dealing with or dating a Cancer, definitely watch that video, because a lot of these cards did come out. So again, what they are saying here is that this is something that develops based off circumstance. So it's not a person that you would ideally connect with or vibe with, but I definitely feel that there's almost like it's a feeling of like, it's very refreshing to you. It could be a person that is very, very like outspoken, they don't mess around. They don't have time to be wasting. So they're very straightforward. And I feel that this is like very refreshing to you. For others of you, it could be that you yourself are actually attracted to an earth sign and you're watching them or looking at what they're doing or looking towards what they're doing and almost like wanting or having some type of hope or desire for that to develop into something. For some of you guys, it could be a long-term friendship, someone that you've known for a very, very long time. And again, you never seen them in that way. But I definitely do see situations developing where you guys are able to vibe on a deeper level. Now, I do want to mention for those of you guys that currently have been working for a company or wherever it is that you're working for at the moment, I feel that there's going to be a developing scenario of a person perhaps kind of like them lacking and they start relying on you for you to step up. I highly encourage you guys to not complain about it, but definitely, definitely step up to the plate, because this is going to in turn put you in a position where there is more authority or more power, meaning they will see certain qualities about yourself that are very much what they're looking for a higher ranking position. And you do have the Wheel of Fortune next to the Eight of Pentacles. So again, I do see that there's going to be a major increase in your finances as well. So definitely, you know, I know a lot of the time, sometimes, you know, we experience where everyone has a set of things that they have to do that is within their responsibility. And a lot of the times we kind of complain when people, you know, just start slacking off and we have to then step up and do more things because we just don't want to get backed up or whatnot. And a lot of the times, like I said, we complain about it, but what Spirit is telling you is, no, don't complain about it. Do the best you possibly can, because people are watching you, because people will be giving you that recognition. They will be, you know, giving you that opportunity of, hey, this is a go-getter. This is a person that we definitely need in an authoritative type of position, because that's the type of energy that you need to inspire other people, kind of like teaching by your own actions. So they're definitely looking towards you, Leo. Definitely step up to the plate, do what you have to do, kind of, you know, swallow your pride a little bit and do what you have to do. Get it done. What they're saying is you're not going to regret it. Now, I'm pulling out a card from the vortex. This is in regards to every single aspect of our lives. Let's see what Spirit has for you guys for this one. And what they're saying is, my imagination attracts all cooperative relationships. The universe and all its physical and non-physical players in it is responding to the vibrations that you are offering, and no distinction is made between vibration that you offer as you were observed or a vibration that you offer as you imagine. It will simply imagine your life as you want it to be. All cooperative components will be summoned, and even more important, all components that are summoned will cooperate. It is the law of attraction. The experience you have with others is about what you evoke from them. So again, like I said, what they're saying here is definitely we can attract relationships, financial situations, business, a specific job that you've been looking for where, you know, maybe sometimes people around you are like, oh, you would never be able to go up the ladder because they, you know, expect some type of educational background, etc. And when we hear that, it kind of brings us down, but they're also conditioning us to believe that that's always unattainable. And what they're telling you in this card is that a lot of attracting and a lot of, you know, being able to manifest what we want starts with our imagination, which is the visualization. Can you see yourself? And if you can see yourself having that job, having that relationship, having that connection, having a perfect harmony within your family,
if you can imagine that, and if you can tune into that emotionally, how is that going to emotionally make you feel? Then you're almost there. All you need to do is surrender to the process to see the manifestation of it. So this is a very beautiful, beautiful message for you, Leos. Again, put your positive vibration out there, and that's exactly what the universe is going to echo back. If you're constantly thinking that you have bad luck, that things always happen to you, that there is never any good, positive things in your life, the more you focus on that, the more the universe echoes back that exact same situation that is going to make you feel that way. So then we experience more, you know, turmoil, more difficulties, more blockages. And what they're telling you is focus on the positive. Focus on the positive, tune into that vibration and see the manifestations happen. So I hope you guys enjoyed this reading, like, share, and comment, and we'll see each other soon. Bye. They keep them, keep them